Training with the first team, camps in Germany, and a professional FIFA player, all that and more on this edition of the Ladcast featuring Antonio Carrera. I'm your host, Sasha Cole, and for this episode, let's set the goal at 50 likes. Can we hit it? It's up to you. Now, on to past Sasha. So before we begin, your handle on Instagram is pelusa.fcd. Is that meaning fluffy in Spanish? Is that where that comes from?
Yeah, ever since I moved to Dallas, my coaches, everyone's always called me Pelusa. I think it's because of my hair, you know?
Yeah.
It all started with my keeper coach calling me Pelusa. Instead of calling me by my own name, he just called me Pelusa, and it's just stuck.
All right, so let's get right into it. It's MLS preseason time, and you're actually training with FC Dallas's first team. Walk us through your experience so far.
I mean, especially the first couple of days, obviously you're going to be a little bit nervous going with the first team. They're way older and way more physically developed. But honestly, after the first 2 days, I let my nerves go out. You know, first day jitters, you know how it is. I just came out and I just knew I was there for a reason and played how I know how to play. You know, I performed how I know how to perform. I know I'm there for a reason. And it's the sport I love. It's soccer, it's football, you know. I wouldn't be doing anything else. And to be at the preseason with the FC Dallas's first team is an honor.
You've previously trained with the Academy at Dallas and also the USL affiliate North Texas. What's the step up been like and now coming into the first team?
It's the speed of play and intensity that every player has, you know, especially with the Academy. With the Academy, the speed of play is a bit lower. Not everybody needs to be there. Everybody wants to be there, but not everybody needs to be there. Not everyone's fighting for their spot there, you know, with the pros, especially with the first team. That's how they maintain their food for their family, you know, their wife, their kids, everything. So it's more than just a job. It's a lifestyle for everyone there. And I think that's what the main difference is.
On your last Instagram post, I noticed that Michael Barrios commented. He's now at Colorado Rapids, formerly of Dallas. Have you become acquainted with some of the guys in the first team already?
I've trained like before this preseason. I trained maybe 2, 3, 4, 5 times with the first team. Spontaneous training, though, was not nothing like the preseason. Barrios was always very welcoming ever since I got there. You know, he welcomed me open arms. And he's just been really nice to me. Even now that he's in Rapids, he sends me like, hey, man, don't worry. Don't get nervous. You know, you're good. Don't worry. Just play how you know how to play, stuff like that. It's been amazing. And it's really calmed me down, especially the first couple of days with the first team.
Were you expecting to be training so early on in your career at the first team?
I mean, ever since I was a little kid, my dream's always been to be the best keeper in the world, you know, and I've always dreamed of doing it as quick as possible. And, you know, I don't really look at where I am, but where I want to be. And I just make sure every day I perform. And now I did expect a little bit to be with the first team. I had a good season. In a total of 6 league games with the Academy, I only got scored on 3 times. I thought I was performing good and deserved a spot to be with the first team.
You have trained at Dallas since you were 11 years old, which is a system that has had Weston McKennie, Brian Reynolds, and Jonathan Gomez, amongst others. To you, what's the secret sauce that makes Dallas so special of an academy?
And I think it's how close everyone is from the first team to the U10s, you know, it's insane. You'll out of nowhere have first team players coming down to watch the U12 Academy. You know, there's a big connectivity and a united family there. And I think it motivates all the young players to try to strive for that, you know?
If you could pick one player that you've played with at the Academy so far, pick a player that you think could potentially make it big.
I'd say Nico Carrera, for sure. No, he's his mentality, the way he plays. I mean, you rarely see a center back dribble through the whole team and then score a banger. You know, that's something only Nico does.
Yeah, I think I have to agree with you, man. Nico, big things. You guys, whole team Carrera, man. I love that mentality that you guys have. In January 2018, we were called up into the U.S. Under-15s camp. Members included Brandon Craig and Rokas Bukstas of the Ladcast Academy, of course, as well as Tony Leon and others. How's your first camp with the guys?
I mean, it was amazing. It was, I think, the very first camp of the 04 generation. And ever since the beginning, you know, I've always kept in touch with everyone, you know, asked them how they're doing. They asked me, you know, it's still family, and the level, it's different going from club to national team. You know, that's the highest honor you can get. And the level of soccer is, it's amazing. You know, it's something that you rarely see. And recently, I also got called up to the U17 U.S. national team as well. But with everything with COVID, it's complicated with COVID.
Have you continued to keep in contact with maybe people in specific in that camp and in that generation?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I've kept in contact mainly with goalkeepers.
Yeah,
you know, of course. We're a tight-knit family with Gaga, Gabriel Solina, Damien Alguera. It's mainly keepers, you know. It's a tight-knit family. And then players of Leo Torres from San Antonio, Rocky Perez, Josema from Sacramento. Those are to name a few.
If you ever had the choice, what would it mean to you to represent your nation, whether it be U.S. or Mexico?
I mean, it'd be the greatest honor I could have, you know, especially to win a World Cup with them. It'd be amazing. And whether it be Mexico or the U.S., I'm a Mexican-American. I'm proud to say that. I'm proudly Mexican-American, whether it be Mexico or USA. I would kill myself on the field for them. I would do everything and anything in my power for them, you know, to win a World Cup, to bring the World Cup trophy back home. It'd be no words. It'd leave me speechless.
So in summer of 2019, you and several other MLS Academy keepers and coaching staff went over to Munich for a week-long masterclass in the art of goalkeeping. What do you remember from your Germany trip?
It was amazing. You know, all the keepers, everyone was in the same hotel. We all trained together. I think what I remember the most was the final day. The last day there, everyone's happy. Everyone's a bit sad that we're all going to leave home. But it's just competition. Everyone's smiling. Everyone's having fun. We're playing keeper wars. It's amazing. Going to teams, some individual competition. Everyone's just laughing and really living life, living the life of football, you know. That's what football is. Just enjoying yourself and your teammates and everyone around you. And enjoying the beautiful game.
Was there an aha moment at this camp? Maybe something that you've picked up into your game from that you learned there?
Yeah, I would say the block save, which is, I don't know, it's the Neuer special. Whenever he goes into the you know, when he gets big, I think I really learned that from, especially the German coach. They taught me how to probably get set and where to put your feet, your hands, everything. How to learn how to do the block save. Because before that, I would just go crazy, you know. I wouldn't have any really technique with it. I would just go at them and try to scare the forward. You know, maybe scream in his ear, say boo, I don't know. But yeah, I learned the block safe technique from the German coaches.
So speaking on Germany, your older brother, of course, Nico, would go on to make his move to Deutschland just a year later. How has Nico inspired you growing up on and off the pitch?
He always taught me how to do everything right, you know. If it's schoolwork or cleaning the kitchen, doing the house chores or playing soccer, do everything right and give everything your all, you know, because, you know, he's had his hard share of in his soccer career and he's always persevered. You know? That's something I've admired about him. That's something I idolize about him. You know, I don't think I would be without where I am without him. You know, he's taught me so much and his actions speak louder than words. You know, he got cut. He didn't care. He just kept working. And now look at him. He's in Holstein Kiel, playing with the U23s, and it's just an idol to play. Like an idol. He's my idol. You know, I want to be like him. His mentality and the way he plays everything. It's amazing.
For you, is following in the footsteps of Nico and moving to Europe your ultimate goal?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, my ultimate goal is to be the best keeper in the world, and I think going to Europe is the pathway to that. If it's going to be a 16 years old or 20, we will see. But yeah, that's obviously the pathway. I would love to play for Manchester United, though. You know, rep the red jersey. You know, number 13 in the back. You know, it'd be amazing playing at Old Trafford. That'd be my dream.
How's your family motivated you and helped you to become who you are today?
Yeah, I mean, ever since we were little, my dad has always said family over everything, you know. Nico's got a game, we all go, we all support him. If he plays good, we cheer him on. If he plays bad, we motivate him to do better. If I play good, it's the same thing, you know, for everyone. We all go to everyone's games. We're always there for each other to motivate each other and to do better. You know, we're a tight family, and no matter what will happen, we will always be there for each other, good or bad.
Who's the best footballer out of you all?
It's hard. footballers? I'm not going to say who, you know, but... I'm not gonna, you know, I'm not going to
gotcha.
Say.
Yeah. I gotcha.
You know, if Nico's watching this, he knows.
Definitely. Okay, now for the real question, who's the best FIFA player?
Oh, that's me, 100%.
Of course, yep.
Yeah. Nico's going to know that. That's that's me. You know, I beat him at FIFA. My little brother. No, my little brother's 11 years old, and he gets, Gold 1, Elite 3, and which is insane. But, no, I'd say me, yeah.
Yeah, so speaking on FIFA, you're actually very nutty at FIFA. You're I believe, 1 point ranked, what is it, like 407th in the world in Foot Champs? Check out Team Carrera streaming on Twitch and YouTube, by the way. What's it like to be both a professional footballer and FIFA player?
I mean, obviously, it sounds like the dream, but it's actually pretty hard, you know. Yeah. Coming off of this tiring game on Saturday, you just want to get home and sleep. But you have to play a couple of Foot Champs games, or if you have the E-Global Series qualifiers, you have to play those, and those are exhausting, not just because mentally it's just tiring. It's not so much physically like it is playing real soccer, but it's exhausting mentally, you know. And sometimes you need to just sleep or get some rest through yoga, do something instead of playing esports. But you got to do what you got to do.
What do you hope for the future of your YouTube and Twitch streams?
I just want to keep enjoying it, honestly. I just want to grow big and have a big community to share my journey with, not just soccer-wise, but also esports-wise, FIFA-wise. You know, I just want a big community that I can share that with, and so that they can experience what I'm experiencing as well.
Do you have any stories in your career so far that you could tell?
Liga MX International, we played against the likes of Atletico Madrid, Chivas, Pachuca. I came in as, I think, the second goalkeeper. I was playing, I think, a year up or 2 years up. And I came in as a second keeper. And then out of nowhere, the coach says, Tony, you're playing. It was against Chivas. And Chivas needed to win that game to make it to the final. And then I came up. I had, I think, 14 saves that game.
That's Tim Howard level right there.
Oh, yeah. No, it was an insane game. It was amazing. And afterwards, some little kid asked me for my gloves. And it was the very first time someone offered me that. And nice. I was overwhelmed with joy. I took a picture with him. He didn't take a picture of me. I felt like I took a picture with him. Yeah. I gave him my gloves. I signed them. It was one of the once in a lifetime experience.
All right. So to round out the podcast, again, thank you so much for your time. What's the goal that you have for the upcoming year and maybe even past that?
My goal for the upcoming year is finish the preseason with the first team. Maybe a contract comes up. Play the season with the USL team. Mm-hmm. Have a great season. You know, have a average of 0.5 goals per game.
Perfect amount of numbers.
Yeah, you know, it's precise. Have the most clean sheets in the season out of all the keepers, and bring a USL League One title to North Texas and to FC Dallas.
Tony, it's been a pleasure. Thanks very much for your time. I'm looking forward to Team Carrera dominating the men's, women's, and esports World Cups. The whole trio, everything out there. Thanks for your time, and enjoy signing to the Ladcast Academy.
I can't wait. I'm following it every day on TikTok.
That's what we like to hear. All right, man.
Thank you, man.
Yeah.